is Bloomberg UTV.
What do we all aspire for? What do we all work towards? A good life, some comforts, perhaps small pleasures. Now, it all requires money. It all comes at a cost. Money can be a good friend, but if not handled well, it can turn into your biggest foe, driving you deep into a sea of debt. And coming out of such an ocean is not an easy task. That's what this show is all about. Real life turnaround stories. Real people who've managed to overcome the odds. People who've managed to come from debt to life. Mr. Subramaniam Iyer lives in Hyderabad with his wife Gayatri and his newly born 10-month-old son Dhruva.
Hi, my name is Subramaniam. Well, I was working with a company called and the recent economic recession and all this affected us really badly. And the client actually downsized the numbers that we had. So I've been one of the victims of corporate downsizing. So this happened in the month of July. And from July on, I've been searching for a job, trying my best to get into elsewhere, but...
He was let go, the reason being downsizing of the company, while his wife had to quit work as she was expecting. Gayatri didn't have the option of taking maternity leave since she was on probation, and the company contract didn't allow her the benefit of paid maternity leave.
I joined in the month of May. I got to know about my pregnancy in the month of June, July. I said, yes, I'm working in the nights. So it's a calling profile and all. It's a little, hectic job what I'm doing.
Okay.
So she said, I'll give you some pills so that,
The Iyers are under approximately 7 lakh rupees of debt. This comes from 6 credit cards, 5 personal loans and 1 housing loan.
It initially started out with my credit cards. I would call myself immature in the beginning. I swiped my card left, right, center, and then when the time had come to pay, I had my own issues. I paid for some time, and then I realized that I was not doing it right. I was just paying it off for good. I was not paying it for good. I was just paying the interest part, and the principal was still outstanding all the time. And initially starting off, it was around 29,000 on one card and 29,000 on the other card. And later, when I was paying over a year after me paying 3,000 to each card, so that's 6,000 per month, after paying 72,000, I still owed the bank put together 50,000. So that was like, debt on debt, and I wanted to come out of it. So then I happened to take a personal loan to pay off the credit cards. Now that once I paid my credit cards, I just had to pay the personal loan guy a certain amount of money every month. And then later, my cards were totally free again. So that actually meant that, again I was into the trap and all. Now, one thing was, there were lots of things that were happening in my life too. I was getting married and my mom was in a hospital.
Our experts looked into the Iyer family's case. Till 7 lakhs in debt, 6 credit cards, outstanding amount on the cards of 1,50,000 rupees. So that's basically a little bit about their total psyche. So if you talk about the total loans.
And the figures that you see is the outstanding amount.
Outstanding. Yeah, the outstanding are there. Is outstanding.
Yeah, the liability is divided there in two parts. One is the critical liability and then there's the good liability. Good liability is the home loan. So that's 4 lakhs of critical liability and 3.5 lakhs of home loans, which works out to almost 7.5 there, which you see the total liability figure down there.
We said, can you simply move in with your in-laws for the time being, with the girl's family, reduce the outgo on rent? They were very iffy about that. They're both out of jobs right now. She is hopeful of starting something in the next few weeks. Her company should take her back because she set the house out for herself. She's very clear that this is for her parents. She is quite clear about her PF money, so right. It seems she is...
good value, mm-hmm. And it's take away at least 2-3 credit cards out of the way.
Okay.
of course, the first thing is that first we negotiate on the credit cards.
Right.
We negotiate on the credit cards. There are two aspects of any kind of a transaction. One is the principal, other is the interest and penalties. Now, principal is something on which they have spent, and probably Visa or whoever they have paid through their resources. And that money has got to be paid back. The interest is a cushion on that for the banks, and the service charges and other taxes or whatever. That part can be waived by the bank, because bank is going to, all right, to some extent their incomes will be suppressed or not to that extent. But they cannot in any way waive off the principal amount.
Oh well, I have two policies. I have three policies to be precise. One policy, and all three policies were taken by my dad, not me. And all the three are with LIC. And all the three, none of them are in equity or market linked. All of them, one is Jeevan Anand, one is Bima Gold, and one more is very old, Jeevan Akshay or something, very old policy. Now, these policies, if I, and she has one policy with LIC. Now, yes, at this point in time, we are paying for a policy for Dubai, but these are the only four policies that we have. None of them are market linked. Because if they are market linked, recently when the Sensex went above 17,000, maybe we could have, you know, done something good with that.
Gayatri has a house in her name which she purchased before marriage. She took a loan of 3,80,000 rupees for the same. The EMI on this loan every month is 3,800 rupees, but it's not her and Subbu who stay in that house, but her parents. The Iyers live in a house just opposite this house, and they shell out an additional 3,000 rupees as rent on their accommodation.
A fairly interesting case, not something which looked sort of irreparable. And the kind of financial sums that we were working with were not very big, very humongous. It just seemed like a case of A, faulty planning, bad decisions being made, and B, somewhere I got a sense that they clearly were spending beyond their means. Now, while this point had been realized, or had, you know, Mr. Iyer had come to terms with it, and he sounded like he knew that he had gone wrong, it took a while for this point to sort of come through from Gayatri. I don't know whether it was a little bit of self-esteem to accept that a mistake had been made. She kept saying that no, these were right things, these were right decisions. If the times weren't wrong, we would have been okay. If the times weren't wrong, if we hadn't lost the job, we would have been fine. But it took a long argument to actually convince her that good times or bad times, you cannot have 10 outstanding loan amounts either on a credit card or with a bank at any given point in time.
Gayatri, first tell me, you were earning a salary of around 8,000 before marriage when you decided to go in for a home loan. Why did you do that? What was the thinking on that?
When you asked that, you know, how was she able to manage? I'm like, no, if you were asking, see, she took the loan before she got married, okay? Correct. Or before we got married, actually. Correct. And at that point in time, her mom was working. If you were asking how was she able to manage the show and everything, her mom was working, and additionally her dad was on and off a job. Alright, so you know, she was able to manage.
But you had to give a part of your salary to run the expenses of the house as well.
Yes.
Because your father was on and off. I understand that you have not been a spendthrift and you've been very prudent in your savings. But did you not think that you are taking a big financial responsibility at a very young age?
It's not a personal loan or a credit card, so that I have to repent on something else. It is a kind of an investment. I thought, okay, getting an asset is a good investment I'm making at the age of 23-24 years. When I look back, yes, it's a good thing I have done in my life. That's what I think now.
Okay.
Because I have a own house. Though I am in a problem now, yes, that's the kind of asset I have in hand. Because even though these kind of loans I repay, yes, I'm not getting anything. This is the one, if I repay, I'm getting some kind of
asset. Okay. It's a good point, and that can be debated. We will do that with the financial experts when we sit with them. I just wanted to understand where you were really coming from. Difficult circumstances, and therefore, of course, you had to take up these loans to get the basics going. But just in terms of financial behavior, was it the right thing to do? I understand you wanted it, obviously, a television set when you move in, and you had to have your basic expenses through. But you realize, you took a loan realizing that your current income levels are not supporting the lifestyle you're going out to the marketplace to buy, whether it's a fridge or a TV or a DVD, I don't know, whatever small assets that you might want in your house.
You knew that you can't afford it, which is why you're going ahead and taking a loan on day-to-day functional things.
On this survey, what I like to tell is, I was working at that point in time, and I admit maybe to a certain extent I was a spendthrift. When they say I was a spendthrift, I used to spend money. You know, I never even maybe sometimes I don't think what's going to happen tomorrow.
Hmm.
Now, if I can do this, if I have the required resources to do this, maybe I'll do it.
Hmm.
All right. Now, maybe after marriage, many things change. You know, maybe I have to seriously, when I see something, if I want to buy, actually think, you know, twice or thrice over it, maybe discuss it with Gayatri, for which obviously she'll say no. But again, maybe discuss, and, you know, I'm, you know, coming down on that. But again, I was working. Gayatri was working.
You were getting around 15,000 in hand
yeah.
at that time, and she was getting around 8,000 in hand.
So 23,000
of 23,000.
Yes. The initial loan which we took
was about 50,000.
Not 50,000, yeah. Initially, the loan, first loan we took was 50,000, and the 1,71,000 we took.
No, I'm talking about the UTI loan, which was primarily to set up things in the house after your marriage.
Exactly.
So I want the justification for this 50,000 loan when you guys were earning about 23,000 between yourselves, 22,000 between yourselves. There was no rush. You have all the time in front of you to gradually acquire things, whether it's a microwave, whether it's a TV, whether it's a fridge. But it's a question of asking yourself the question, I can't afford it this month or over the next 6 months. Should I save and then buy these assets?
Subbu, Mr. Iyer, he spends. He spends without thinking. I mean, he'll go out and buy four dresses for his son instead of two, when maybe only one is required. So he's an extravagant man. I wouldn't say extravagant in the sense of lavish, but he wants to live the good life without really thinking about his expenses and his means. He wants to live the good life, but he's not being able to sort of measure his means and live within that parameter. That's where his primary fault lies. I think on the case of Gayatri, while she has more financial prudence and sense, I don't think it was being channelized in the right manner. For example, she had a provident fund, which she was very clear she did not want to touch. Then there was the question of finding a job. Both Subramaniam and Gayatri have been frantically looking for offers and are constantly on the phone chasing potential employers.
I was just, you know, forwarding my resume to you so that, you know, you can. Alright. I'll just send across my resume to you. I believe she had been very supportive in terms of getting me a loan. Getting me a loan whenever I wanted. She's been always there to support for, but when, you know, right now what I'd like to say is she's been supportive throughout. The financial mess that I would love to say it, I am in, but unfortunately that we are in right now. Yes, there has been some planning that gone terribly wrong somewhere. Something somewhere went really wrong. Sure, what I expect is, if I may add one more thing, till recently, yes, it was only me and Gayatri, but now that we have Dhruva also in the picture, I'm sure as parents, you know, what I believe in is, I need to be in a position to do whatever he wants, by not borrowing, from the resources that I have. So that's the way I would like to be. From what I foresee is, apart from the home loan, all the other loans, if I were to pay, you know, if I were to sit down today, plan them and pay, I'm sure in the next couple of years or 1 year, I'm sure I will not have them. And going forward, once I get into a job, what I like to do is, you know, maybe keep the, maybe the major chunk of the money should go for saving, for Dhruva at least. And maybe buy another house. I mean, I don't want to be in this place. I mean, it's all due respect to this house. I want to buy another house, a bigger house maybe.